ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ವೆಂಕಟನಾಥಾರ್ಯ ಕವಿತಾರ್ಕಿಕ ಕೇಶರಿ ವೇದಾಂತಾಚಾರ ವರಿಯೋಮೇ ಸನ್ನಿಧತ್ತಾಂ ಸದಾಹೃತಿ ಎಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಅಮೇಝಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಫುಲ್ ಆಫ್ ನೈಚ್ಯಾನುಸಂಧಾನಂ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಟರ್ಲಿ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಲೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲೋಲಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಆಳವಂದಾರ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ why he had mentioned papatma, that he is the personification of papams in the last verse, and he elaborates on that in this verse number 62. It's not applicable and appropriate for Swami Alavandar to talk about himself like this, and Acharya is so compassionate and such a daya nidhi. He has composed this not explicitly telling that we are like that. In spite, he says, by composing this way, when we recite, we would remind or understand ourselves of our lowliest nature and have this right anusandhanam, not even naicha anusandhanam, right anusandhanam of what we actually are and rectify ourselves. That's the intent, in my humble opinion. 62nd verse. Amaryadaha kshudraha chalamati asuya prasavabhuhu kritagno durmani smaraparavasho vanjanaparaha drisamsaha papishtaha katamahamito dukkha jalade aparadutirna stava paricharyam sharanayohu. My most favorite verse. Amaryadaha, what a soul-stirring verse. One cannot but cry reciting this, feeling repenting, regretting of who we are and what we are, and imagine ourselves as the hero of the verse. Amaryadaha, one who has crossed the boundaries and established rules, the sastric injunctions. Kshudraha, engaging in trivial worldly pursuits, material pursuits, worldly pleasures, carnal desires, sense organs, all that. Chalamadhi, never study, sanchalam, fickle mind. Asuya prasava bhuhu, a place where asuya is born, jealousy is born. Kritagnaha, ungrateful one, never ever be grateful, never ever think of what others did good to us. Durmani, ill feeling towards fellow human beings, harm feelings, to do harm to them, to think ill of them. Smaraparavashaha, falling into the desires and sensual impulses. Smaraparavashaha, vanchanaparaha, skillfully deceiving, cheating, and deluding others. Vancharapara, drisamsaha, engaging in violent act, engaging in harming others in terms of words, in terms of thoughts, in terms of actions. And papishtaha, incorrigible sinner, mahapapi. So that's what it, apara uttirna tava paricharyam sharaneyo. When such is the case, katamahamiko dukkha jalate, I am in the dukkha jaladehe, means I am in the ocean of sorrows, ocean of grief. And aparad, I cannot see the shores. And aham, ita, such, me, such, adiyen. Uttirna tava paricharyam sharanayoho. How will I be able to reach the shores, reach the bay, come to the shores, get saved, and perform service, kainkaryam at your lotus feet. Tava paricharyam khatam sharanayoho. How is it possible? When will it be possible? How is it? How, in which manner it is possible when I am such a papatma? So, Swami Desikan mentions that this is similar to Namalvar saying, Nichanen nirai onrumilen yenkan pasham vaitta paranjudar shodike. Similar to that, naichyanusantanam. Acharya mentions in the Stotra Arambha Bhashyam that yatyap yatra nasandrishtam parartha pratipadanam తథాపి దాదృగ్రూపత్వం గ్రూపత్వం పరసంకల్పత స్థితం. సో ఎవ్రీవన్ బీ ఫ్రమ్ హయర్ క్యాస్ట్ ఆర్ లోవర్ క్యాస్ట్, బీ దే లిటరేట్ ఆర్ ఇల్లిటరేట్, బీ దే జ్ఞానీస్ ఆర్ అజ్ఞానీస్, దే నీడ్ టు థింక్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్సెల్స్ యాజ్ అబౌవ్ లిస్టెడ్ క్వాలిటీస్ హౌస్డ్ ఇన్ హిమ్, యాజ్ దర్ ఇస్ నన్ హూ ఇస్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ ఎక్సెప్ట్ శ్రీఅప్పతి శ్రీమన్నారాయణన్ అండ్ మహాలక్ష్మి. సో ఈవన్ ఇఫ్ వన్ డస్ నాట్ డూ, వన్ డస్ నాట్ యాక్ట్ ఫుల్లీ ఇన్ అకార్డెన్స్ విత్ ద శాస్త్రాస్, ఇఫ్ హీ హ్యాస్ ద కంపాషన్ టు ఆల్ బీయింగ్స్ ఈక్వలీ, అహింస ద 8 గుడ్ క్వాలిటీస్, అహింస ప్రథమం పుష్పం అండ్ ఆల్ దాట్, ఆత్ అహింస సెన్స్ కంట్రోల్ కైండ్నెస్ టు ఆల్, ఫోర్బియరెన్స్ జ్ఞానం, పెనన్స్ కాంటెంప్లేషన్, ట్రూత్ఫుల్నెస్ ఆర్ ద 8 మెంటల్ ఫ్లవర్స్, దెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్, దెన్ ద గౌతమ ధర్మ సూత్ర సెయిడ్, దెన్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ బ్రహ్మ ప్రాప్తి. But I have 10 bad qualities here, the mind, speech and body, everything is included. The fruits for these bad qualities is immeasurable sorrows and appears like a deep ocean of suffering. There does not appear to be any shore in the vicinity. How am I able to stay afloat? I need to jump up only to the sky, as that is the only way out. Because this is deep ocean of sorrows and that's not possible for me. I mentioned Nimajjami, I'm going down and down in the last verse. Nimajjami, so please lift me, but where is the hand? I'm not able to even raise my hand above waters. I'm not able to even raise and elevate myself to come to the water surface. And this prakriti spreads everywhere in all 8 directions. The very boundary is the Paramapadam, which is Virajanadi. So, with all my doshams enlisted above, how can I reach you? Only you, being the Sharanagata Vatsalan, need to save me. When will I ever be saved and be able to perform Kaikaryam at your lotus feet? In spite of being born from great Vamsam, Nathamuni Vamsam, I am falling down and down and immersed in samsaric ocean. How will I be able to even utter your name? One may ask, how does Alavandar have all these bad qualities as enlisted by him? It's not meant for him, it's meant for us, as I mentioned. So let's look at these qualities which he has referred to. Amaryadaha vayasa karmanor tasya shrutas yabijanasya cha veshavag వృత్తి సారూప్యత్ ఆచరణ్ విచరేదిహ. సో బేస్డ్ ఆన్ వన్స్ ఏజ్, బేస్డ్ ఆన్ వన్స్ డ్యూటీస్ మీన్స్ ద వర్క్ ద ప్రొఫెషన్, బేస్డ్ ఆన్ వన్స్ ఇన్కమ్, బేస్డ్ ఆన్ వన్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్, బేస్డ్ ఆన్ హిస్ కులం ద బర్త్ ద వంశం, బేస్డ్ ఆన్ హిస్ వేషం ద ఫామ్ అండ్ హిస్ speech and his sustenance, the survival. Based on that, we need to act in tandem, in cognition, in cognizance of these things. What's our age, what's our education, what's our profession, what's our kulam, what's our vesham, means the form that we adorn, what's our talk, how do we talk, and what is our survival, how do we have a day-to-day activities for monetary wealth. Now, in accordance with that, we need to perform our day-to-day conduct, says Manu. If you go against this, it is amaryadaha, kshudraha. I've been performing lowliest acts, means it's as if I'm selling my education, selling my jnanam. We need to have our education and jnanam to uplift ourselves and be saved for our jivatma. And one Maharishi feels bad and regrets that people are learning in order to sell their education to others. And it's like the prostitute selling their bodies, he compares. So similarly, Adiyen is Kshudraha, and Kshudraha means it is engaging in trivial worldly pursuits, material benefits. Kshudraha, chalamati. Chalamatihi is sanchalam and never steady. And even if somebody has got a buddhi towards good things, to perform good things, if he gets angry sometimes, it is okay. But one who is having sanchala buddhi, even if he performs good deeds, punyams, it is cruel and wild, because we never know when will he go haywire. Asuya prasava bhuhu, jealousy is completely unacceptable. In Gita 18.67, Krishna says, nacha mam yobhya bhuyati, means never ever tell these things to a person who is jealous of me, says Krishna to Arjuna. And even Lakshmi tells the Brahman, asuya kaya mamam daha, in Manusmriti. And he says, if somebody is jealous, do not show me to him, says Mahalakshmi to a Brahmanan, to a Brahmin. That never ever introduce Mahalakshmi to a person who is asuya prasavabhu, who is the personification of jealousy, who talks ill about others just because they are jealous. Kritagnaha, one who does not remember the good things done by people, good things done by Bhagavatas towards us. And Adiyan is a personification of that. And we, like the in Kishkindha Kandam, Valmiki also says that the one who has killed the cow, the one who drinks alcohol, the one who is a thief, and the one who does not do vratam, what he is supposed to do, and one who is ungrateful, one who never ever thinks of good things what others did to him, ungrateful person, kritagnaha, there is no prayaschittam for them. And there is a prayaschittam for the one who has killed cow, the one who has drunk alcohol, one who is a thief, one who has not performed their vratam. For them, there is a prayaschittam in the sastras, but never for a kritagnan, one who is ungrateful. And next is durmani. Durmani is one who is having ill feeling towards fellow human beings and thinks that he is the ahank, I, mind. Ishwaroham aham bogi. Asura sampat was mentioned by Gita, Krishna, in Gita 16.14. Ishwaroham, I am the Ishwaran. And people have the vesham of sadhus and perform adharmas and completely deceive and cheat the fools and the naive people, innocent, and pose as if they are panditas, and they cause harm to the sadhus. And the one, and Vidura tells Dhritarashtra, the one who thinks proud of himself, having a false pride, the one who goes on gossiping, the one who has greed, the one who has tremendous anger, and the one who causes harm to his own friend, all these are sharp weapons which completely cuts asunder the person's life, says Vidura to Dhritarashtra. So never ever be a durmani, having ill feeling towards fellow human beings. Smara paravashaha, even the Maharishis are tortured by the cruel Manmatan, the Cupid. The women are like the fire, the men are like the ghee, and we should never ever have the parastri sambandham, parastri desire. So perasayatra ullam, the mind which doesn't have any greed, and there is no lie, not being a liar, and not being not doing any harm to others. All these things are themselves required for Keshava Aradhanam, says Sri Vishnu Dharmam Shaunaka. So, one, Bhagavan himself says, Pararandreshu Jatyantaha, Paradhareshu Apumsakaha, Parivadeshu Ye Mukaha, Tetiva Dayita Mama, in Sri Vishnu Dharmam, which means one who acts as blind from the birth when they look at others' follies, defects, mistakes, they act as if they have been congenitally blind. Right from their birth, they are blind. By closing their eyes to the others' faults, mistakes, defects, thereby not seeing their bad things, seeing only their good things. Secondly, the one who does not even look at lustfully at other spouses, and that is behave as if they are napumsakas. And the third one, who is mute, and one who is mute when they would like to talk about and gossiping about others. They are all very dear to me, says Srivan Narayana. Vanjana paraha, one who deceives others, one who skillfully deceives others, cheats others. Odumeen voda, urumeen varumanavum, vadi irukkumam kok. They will wait for somebody to get into the trap and then cheat. Drishamsaha, one who engages in violent acts. Sapapishtaha, such incorrigible sinner, me, aham. And Swami Desigan goes on to explain very many, he has got a numerous list in his Bhashyam. And I'm even scared to talk about that, because we fall into that very much. And hence, we would stop at this. He is a one who is a papishtan, incorrigible sinner, as we mentioned above. Such an incorrigible sinner, aham. How am I able to even reach the shore unless you save me, O Bhagavan, Sriman Narayana. Tava paricharyayam sharanayoho. Uttirna, here anishta nivritti is referred to. And tava paricharyayam sharanayoho, ishta prapti is referred to. Ishtam is, I would like to follow you at all places. Yena ke, yena yena data gacchati, tena tena saha gacchati. Wherever Emperuman takes avataram, the Muktan goes there performing kaikaryam. Thus, we will be with him at all times, under all circumstances, in all situations, performing eternal kaikaryam with him. Olivil kalamellam udanai manne valvila adimai seiya vendum naam thalikulal arivi thirivengadathi elilgol jodi ende thandai thandaikke. So we will perform uninterrupted, blemishless kaikaryam if he only remind us ourselves of our papams, of our bad qualities, and pray to him for saving us. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sandidattam Sadahruti. So, the Lord Sriman Narayana asked Alavandar, you are declaring yourself to be amaryadaha, kshudraha, drisamsaha, papishtaha, all that. So how will I be able to tolerate all these transgressions against sastras with a small excuse of performance of saranagati? The Lord appeared to be asking, and Alavandar responds, Yamunacharya, you may appear to be asking, Bhagavane, but there is evidence that you have even accepted much bigger and huge aparadams and apacharams, and also even much lower action as an excuse. And the sloka comes here, number 63. Raghuvara yadabhustvam dhadrisho vayasasya pranata iti dhayalu यच्च चैद्यस्य कृष्णा प्रतिभवम् अपराद्दुर् मुक्त सायुज्यदो भूः वद किम् अपदम् आगस्तस्य तेऽस्ति क्षमायाः रघुवर श्री रामबिनाने द वन हू हेल्ड फ्रम श्री रघुवंशम तादृश वायसस्य द ह्यूज सिन पापम वाज परफॉर्म्ड बाय काकासुर एंड द क्रो प्रणत इति एंड बिकॉज ही फेल एट युवर फीट त्वं दयालु यदा भू त्वं दयालु यू बिकेम अ दयालु यू बिकेम अ करुणा सागर यू बिकेम यू टुक सो मच पिटी ऑन हिम एंड यू आर सो कंपैशनेट टू फॉरगिव हिम यत एंड फर्दर कृष्णा ओ कन्नबिराने कृष्णा प्रतिभवम अपराधु प्रतिभवम अपराधु इन एवरी बर्थ अपराधु चैत्यस्य इन एवरी बर्थ दट शेति कुल शिशुपालन चैत्यस्य सो चेति कुल शिशुपालन इन एवरी बर्थ ही कमिटेड अपराधम्स एंड अपचारम्स फॉर यू एंड ऑन हिम आल्सो यू टुक पिटी एंड यू शवर्ड युवर मर्सी एंड सायुज्यद अबूहु यू गेव हिम सायुज्यम You granted him your lokam. Tasyate chamaya. Thus, there is no way that one needs to do to for your chamaya, for your forgiveness. And what is the papam that I have committed, which you cannot forgive? Please tell me. So the message is. Oh, the zenith of Raghuvamsa, the Vamsa that was known for the protection of those who have performed Saranagati. When the Kakasura fell on the ground, even in the other direction, it is Sita Pirati who turned the Kakasura towards you and you accepted the same falling, just accidentally falling. Accepted the same as if it is Sharanagati at your feet and you pardoned its aparadam then and there. You appeared as if you do not even know or realize the apacharam committed by the asura and you most compassionately condemned the kakasura. What's the reason? Because you are such a karuna sagara. And you are the sweetest Krishna. Even on the incorrigible papi, Sisupala, who was insistent and bent upon committing only apacharams on you, ceaselessly, uninterruptedly, what's that you granted? Why is it that you granted moksham to him? It's all due to your vatsalyam and greatest compassion. For such you, what is the apacharam which is not or which cannot be even forgiven or pardoned? Condemned by your patience and compassion. Absolutely nothing. So what is it that I have done which is beyond your forgiveness? You had sent the Astra to kill the Kakasura and finally since it gave up and failed falling at your feet, not even with an intention of performing Saranagati perhaps. Yettijayum udandrodi ilaitthu vilum kahampol முத்தி தரு நகரேலில் முக்கியமாம் கச்சிதனில் அத்திகிரி அருளாளருக்கு அடைக்கலம் நான் தந்தேன் புகுந்தேன் ஸோ எத்திசையும் உடனோடு இழைத்து விழும் காகம் இட் வெண்ட் ஆல் டைரக்ஷன் அண்ட் ஃபைனலி இட் ஜஸ்ட் ஃபெல் அட் யுவர் ஃபீட் யூ ஸ்டில் அக்செப்டட் த சேம் அண்ட் யூ ஜஸ்ட் பிரிக்ட் இட்ஸ் ரைட் ஐ ஆஸ் அ ஸ்மால் பனிஷ்மெண்ட் யூசிங் த அஸ்திரம் விச் வாஸ் ஆல்ரெடி சென்ட் வாட்ஸ் த ரீசன் ஃபார் சச் அ கம்பேஷன் What's the qualification for the Asura to perform Sharanagati? It is well-known fact that Raghuvamsam is known for the protection of Sharanagatas, those who have performed Sharanagati. The Kakasura committed the unpardonable apacharam of pricking and touching the breast of Sita Pirati. Still, your compassion could forgive the same. And even worse was Sisupala. Not just one birth, he had been committing apacharam for 3 consecutive births. When he was Hiranyakshan, Hiranyakashipu, when he was Ravanan, Kumbhakarnan, and then next Shishupalan, Kamsan. He had captured, in the earlier birth, he had captured Pirati and abducted her as Ravanan and talked as a lecher. And in this birth as Shishupalan, he wanted to even marry Rukmini Pirati. He talked in such abusive language in the assembly, talking all names about you in such unparliamentary style, which even harsh for people like Duryodhanan and his brothers. Ketpar Keshavan Kirtiyallal Matrum Ketparo Shetpar Shevi Shudu Kirmai Vashavugale Vayum Shetpal Param Pagaivan Shishupalan. So those who were in the assembly among Kauravas were the likes of Duryodhanan, Duchadanan, Sakuni, Dhritarashtra and all of them. And even them, they could not bear to hear the abusive language spoken by Shishupalan and Krishna. Such horrible vulgarity of words Shishupalan used while talking names on Krishna. And this Shishupalan, when he was born with 3 eyes and 3 hands, and the parents were grief struck looking at the child with 3 eyes and 3 hands, and there was an ashariri walk which was heard that the one who is going to kill him, kill this baby, kill this child when he grows up, he is the one who can cure this particular weird form. And there were many who came and touched, nothing happened. After few days, Kannapiran, Krishna appeared and he came there to this kingdom, Sheti place. And Krishna's aunt's son, Attai Magan, maternal aunt's son, was Shishupalan. And when Krishna came and touched the baby, he became normal. And the third hand and the third eye disappeared. So the parents came to know thus that it is Krishna who is going to kill him when he grows at a later age, later time. Krishna said, "Don't worry." He assured the parents that he would forgive him every day 100 times. He can do blunders or mistakes or aparadams or apacharams 100 times, but not beyond that. And when Shishupalan wanted to marry Rukmini Pirati, and then of course the hatred and the anger on Krishna exponentially increased for Shishupalan. And even after Kamsan was killed, Shishupalan's anger further grew manifold, and at least he would abuse him every day close to 100, but not beyond 100. And during Rajasuya Yagam conducted by Yudhishthira, the first honor was given by Sahadevan to Krishna. And Shishupalan was hurt, and he angered on Panchapandavas, and he started giving abusive language, and he kept on continuing talking all names on Krishna, and it exceeded 100. Immediately Krishna sent his chakram, which completely took away Shishupalan's head and killed him. And that was the story. So Shishupalan thus was killed But Shishupalan was taken to Vishnu Lokam, like Varuna Lokam, like Yama Lokam. Vishnu also has a Lokam, and in that Lokam, the Dwarapalakas Jaya Vijaya, they were there taking care as the gatekeeper. When the rishis wanted to go and visit, pay their obeisance to Vishnu, the rishis were stopped by Jaya Vijaya because they were instructed not to let anyone. And the rishis cursed these two, Jaya Vijaya, to become lords, enemies for three births. And thus came Hiranyakshan, Hiranyakashipu, Ravanan, Kumbhakarnan, Kamsan, Shishupalan. Thus, the chakra was aimed at Shishupalan, and Shishupalan got Sayujyam, the moksham, because number one, he uttered Krishna's name always, even though it was on a negative manner. And he was always thinking of Krishna, even though it was as an enemy. So Gopyaha Kamat Bayat Kamsaha Dveshat Chaityadayo Nripaha Sambandat Krishnayo Yuyam Snehat Bhaktya Vayam Prabho. Srimad Bhagavatam says, in some way, if there is a Bhagavat Sambandham, whether there is a negative way or positive way, there would be Pavanam, there would be cleansing, there would be attainment of good null gati. Yata kayacha vidaya sambandaha satu pavanaha, Sriranga Mahatmyam says. So we also need to think of Krishna all the time, utter his divine names all the time, but not definitely not in Shishupalan's manner, but we can utter his divine names. So Mukta, Swami addresses Perumal as Mukta. Pratibhavam aparadhu Mukta Sayujyadopuhu. Mukta means, in Tamil they say Moddu. Moddu means dull, the one who doesn't understand, one who doesn't comprehend, Moddu. So Perumal is addressed as Moddu, means Avignata. In Sahasranamam there is a nama called Avignata, means Pasyas, Pasyatya Chakshu, Sa Shrunotya Karnaha. Shruti says, even though he sees, he listens, he pretends as if he doesn't know. And that is the Trinamam here. Ittanai Adiyanarku Irangum Nam Aranganaya, Pittanai Petrum Ando Piraviyul Pinangumare. He is called Pittan, means he is crazy after people who utter his names. As long as they utter his divine names, he gives them Sayujyam. He gives them good Nargati, Sadgati. So Sayujyada Abuhu, in that the Jivan Shishupalan has attained equality with Perumal because he had uttered his divine names and he had always thought of divine names. Mama Sadharmyam Agataha Kinkara Mamate Nityam. Gita 14.2 says, Bhogamatra Samyalingacha. Also Brahma Sutram says. So the Mukta attains equality with Sriman Narayana. Saravat Tanmayo Bhavet, Mundaka Upanishad says. He becomes equal to Sriman Narayana. Tasyate astik chamaya kim abatam agaha. So thus, is there any mistake, blunder, papam, sin that you cannot forgive? Definitely you can forgive mine also. Chamayaha, please bless me, have karuna on me. Chanti taste karuna saravi. She is chamakshodasi. Acharya refers to chantiste karuna saravi. So chamakshodasi he refers to and say, please have mercy on me, and I did not commit such monster blunder like Shishupalan, and I also performed Sharanagati as an excuse for your mercy, for your compassion and daya on me. All my papams would not be equal to definitely Shishupalan's. He was cut off with your divine chakra and thus was given antima smriti about you. Hence, all his apacharams were forgiven and he was granted sayujyam. Please bless me also. Have mercy on me, says Alavanda, Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline, Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha, Namo Narayana. Sriman Venkatanatharya Kavitarkika Kesari, Vedanta Acharya Varyome Sannidattam Sadahrade. Okay, Kakasuran, Shishubalan, I had forgiven their apacharams and pardoned them. I closed my eye and let them go. But how can you expect me to do that on everyone? How can you instruct me to do so? You cannot order me to do so. Also, you performed prapatti. After completing your whole life only dehavasanam, at the end, you need to ask for kshama, forgiveness. And how can you ask now? Because there is some more life to go. Alavanda responds saying, Sharanagati has to be performed only once. You only mentioned Rama. And the verse is born. Number 64. Nanu prapanna sagriteva nata tavahamasmiti chayachamanaha tavanukampya smarata pratignyam madekavarjam kimidam vratante. This is the most wonderful slokam. And Swami Alavandar Yamanacharya beautifully reminds Perumal and reinforces his unflinching faith, Mahavishwasam, on Perumal. Natha, you are the chief of everyone. Raghunatha, my Natha, one who has performed Sharanagati once with a desire to be your servant, to perform eternal kaikaryam and pleads for the same. Whoever it is, you have taken a vow, you have taken a vratam, you have taken a pledge that you would never ever forget. Sagrideva prapannaya tavasmidi cha yachate abhayam sarvabhutebhyo dadami yetat vratam mama. You had said in the shore, in the seashore, in front of Vibhishana, during Vibhishana Saranagati. And isn't that your limitless compassion? Such a sankalpam of yours for all you said. And you said, Sagradeva Prapannad Abhayam Sarvabhutebhyo Dadami Sarvabhutebhyo. All jantus, you took a sankalpam to protect all those Saranagatas, whoever they are. And did you say that time, minus Alavanda, Madeka Varjam Kimitam Vratante, did you say except for Alavanda? No, the Vratam was applicable for everyone. A brilliant master stroke of Alavanda to catch Perumal. When the whole army of Sugriva was there along with Rama Lakshmana in the seashore, before crossing the ocean even and going to Lanka, you categorically and clearly made the most wonderful assuaging assurance statement to Vibhishana, declaring your acceptance of Vibhishana Saranagati, no matter who opposes or who supports, and also declaring your sankalpam, your pledge, your vratam to protect all Saranagatas, whoever they are. Sagradeva prapannaya tavasmiti cha yachate abhayam sarvabhutebhyo dadami yetat vratam mama. This famous statement of yours, whenever anyone having performed Saranagati once says, I have realized that I am yours, such person, being, will be granted fearlessness, abhayam, by me, you said, for all future to come. This is my promise. This is my vow, you said, as Sri Ramachandra Murthy. Ramor dhirna abhibhashate Rama never utters twice. And you are Satya, Satya Sankalpan. If anyone approaches you once and performs a Sharanagati saying, I am yours, you entail in him a greatest fearless state of granting him Abhayam. You only said that in front of the whole army. You are Raghunatha and you are my Natha. You, in your infinite Daya, protect all beings thus who take refuge in your lotus feet. And Sakrit Prapannaha, once it is enough. Sakrit Krita Sastrartha, Purva Mimamsai, 11.1.22 Sutram. And this Nyasa Vidyai, Mokshartha Vidyai, also is to be done once. Sagradeva hi sastrataga, Lakshmi Tantram also says, Sagradeva Prapannaya, these very many quotes and references are there, and it can be done only once, and that's adequate. Sakrit Sagasaiva Sarvagasam Nishkritim Akritva. Sri Alvan says like this, Sri Periyavachan Pillai refers. So, and only once it is adequate, and it is for Ishta Prapti as well as for Anishta Nivritti. This once performing Sharanagati is adequate. Anadikalam Samsarittu Ponda Ivan Oru Janmamellam Prapatti Anusandhittal Dan Sakrit Engaikku Porumo Enbar. Sri Periyavachan Pillai Vyakyanam also mentions this. For the whole life, if we have to perform prabhati for the papam that we had done, and is that what Sakrit? And Emperuman immediately forgives then and there. Bhagavat Prabhavatai Parthal Urukalukumel Mihai Prapya Ruchi Prapti Alavam Anuvartikum. Parasara Bhattar says that is also referred to here. So when you see the Bhagavat Prabhavam, the glory and Vaibhavam of Sriman Narayana, his compassion, and for very many millions and millions of births we had committed blunders and transgressions, papams, and the moment you perform the Chana Prabhati, immediate Uttara Chanam, Perumal forgives, and immediately then and there all our papams get burnt. And that is because of the glory of Sriman Narayana, his capability as Sriman Narayana, his Sarveshwaratvam, his compassion. And that if you get to understand a minutest fraction of his glories, that would facilitate us to get that Mahavishwasam, and Bhagavat Ruchi would continue. So and Dadami Sagridev, and Perumal would immediately give Mayi Nichipta Kartavyaha Krita Krityo Bhavishyati Satyaki Tantram, Perumal says. So here Acharya refers to saying that Prachaya Pachaya Dvamsa Pratyuha Rahita Prabho Prapatti Klipta Kaletu Palatin Yapi Suchyate. Swami Desikan mentions a karike here, which is Prachaya Pachaya Dvamsa Pratyuharahita Prabhau Prapatti Klipta Kaletu Palatin Yapi Suchyate. Prachaya, to perform Sharanagati, there is nothing else you have to do. You just need to perform Sharanagati exclusively on its own. Apachaya. For this Sharanagati, the five Anukulyasya Sankalpam, Pratikulyasya Varchanam, those five Angas are required. And there should not be any lesser number of these. These five Angams are required. Dvamsaha. So that Sharanagati would never ever be wasted. Pratyuhaha. For this Sharanagati, three things are to be avoided, which are hurdles for the Sharanagati to get fulfilled, to get completed, to get accomplished. One, lack of Mahavishwasa, lack of unconditional faith, lack of understanding of Perumal's Swamitvam, Vatsalyam, Sausilyam, and his Daya, Karunyam, and his Sarveshwaratvam. That lack of faith should not be there. Number two, Devatantra Sambandham. Perumal alone who can grant moksham. He alone is Mukundan. Moksham dadati iti Mukundaha. No other God can give what he grants. All other celestial bodies, demigods, right up to Rudran, they are also Jivatmas, and they get their powers only from Sriman Narayana. And number three, there is no way that one can commit apacharam to Bhagavata and Acharya. Bhagavata, Acharya, apacharam should not be done. So three, one, lack of Mahavishwasam, two, Devatantra Sambandham, three, Bhagavata, Acharya, apacharam. If these three are not there, Prapatti would automatically transform a person who had somehow, in some manner, yena kena prakarena, so like that, in some way, if the Prapatti had been performed, it would facilitate the soul to transform to a much evolved manner in this birth, and then he or she would be granted moksham in the time at the Dehavasanam, at the time when it was asked for. Natha, he is the chief. Yadiva Ravana Swayam, he is the Emperor who said, either Vibhishana or even Ravana, whoever comes, I would give. Tava Aham Asmi Iti Yachamanaha, Adiyen, Dasan, for you. And I have been contemplating of that, I have been doing Anusandhanam of that, and I have performed Sharanagati, and I am desirous of doing eternal service to you. Na Mukta Kesham, Na Sinam, Na Tavasmiti Vadinam, Manusmriti. And Manu also says, the one who runs amok, the one who sits idle, and the one who considers you as the only Rakshakan, you should not let them down. You should protect. Manu says, so please protect me. Tavaham asmi Goptru Avarna Angam, Nanu Prapanna Sagradeva. Here Perumal, he offers himself as the in at Emperuman's lotus feet. Some people say the first line Manasika Sharanagati and the second line Vachika Sharanagati, others opine, view. And number three, some people say, like Draupadi, for some prayojanam, this Prapatti was performed in the first line, and to get only Emperuman, the second line was made. Second line was composed, and to attain Emperuman's lotus feet, the Prapatti was performed. Some people view, they have their anubhavam of this shlokam. Number four, the first line is Prapatti, second line is Bhakti Yoga. They say all these things are Abhipraya Yojana Vedam, but there is no conflict or contradiction in any of these views, anubhavams. And essentially, Alavandar reminds himself, Perumal, of his Prapatti, of his Sharanagati. Tavanukampyaha, and your Anukampa, your Karuna Patram, I am your Karuna Patram. And you roared in front of Vanarams, in front of Rakshasam, and you said, it is my Vratam, Pratignya, you took a pledge, Abhayam Sarvabhutebhyaha, am I to be excluded out of it? Madekavarjam Kimitam Vratante. So, You said everybody included and you never said minus Alavandar. Swami Srivatsankachari here jocularly refers to one Sri Uve Vidwan Prativadi Bhayangaram Anangaracharya Slokam. Go Brahmanebhya Subhamastu Nityam Gopala Raman Pashuningalaha. He says, Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu, Sri Vaishnavas used to say. So, Loka Samasta, all, everybody should be having Sukham. That is Sri Vaishnavas mentioned. But this particular Brahmin, his neighbor's Pashu, neighbor's cow, has by mistake or it has come and eaten away. So our Brahmin's field, paddy field. So he said, and the neighbor's name is Gopala Raman. So he said, Go Brahmanebhya Subhamastu Nityam. Gopala Raman Pashu Ningalaga. Other than Gopala Raman's Pashu, all other cows should live happily. So like that is your sloka referring to minus Alavandar. So in a jocular manner. So Ramo Dvirna Bibhashate. Rama never utters word twice. And hence you do not go back on your pledge pratam and protect me. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Sriman Venkatanadharya Kavitarkika Keshari Vedanta Acharivaryo Me Sannidattam Sadahirde. We have reached the last verse, number 65. 65 actually is a summation of Ashtaksharam, which is 8, Dvayam 25, plus Charama Slokam 32. Together it is 65. So it's a mixture of, or it is an essence of the Ragasya Traya Mantra. The being immersed in samsaric sagaram, performing thousands and thousands and millions of papams for very many millions of births. Now, being blessed with the right tattva, hita, purushartham, the entities, the way and the goal, the discriminatory power, the vairagya, and having been blessed to perform sharanagati at the Lord's lotus feet, the reason for all this, the mindset which has kind of reached the crescendo of performing prabhati, the culmination is all because of being born as the grandson of Sriman Nathamuni Shrestar, and also Sriman Nathamuni being the pracharya of Swami Alavandar Yamunacharya. Alavandar thus pays his gratitude and prays to the Lord, referring to his Deha Sambandham and Acharya Sambandham with such Acharya Sarvabhauman Sriman Nathamuni. 65th verse. Akritrimatva Charanaravinda Prema Prakarsha Vadimatmavantam Pitamaham Nathamunim Vilokya Prasidamatvruttam Achintayitva. So akritrima tvacharanaravinda prema prakarshavatim atmavantam pitamaham nathamunim vilokya prasida matvrittam achintayitva. Matvrittam, don't look at my achintayitva, don't look at my bad deeds or my behaviors or my papams. Akritrima tvacharanaravinda, without having an unalloyed devotion on his own nature, out of his pure love, affection, devotion, bhakti, he has on your lotus feet prema prakarshavati, he has unlimited, unbounded bhakti. Atmavantam, he is a jnanavan of jivatma and paramatma, the bondage, the difference, the relationship between them, he has got clear jnanaman, jivatma and paramatma. Pitamaham, my grandfather, Nathamuni, Sriman Nathamuni, Vilokya, because of the Sambandham with Sriman Nathamuni as the grandfather and Acharya Sambandham. Please, Kataksham, have a Kataksham on me, proceed, and please forgive me, please consider me, and due to this Acharya grandfather Deha Sambandham. That is what Sriman Nathamuni, my grandfather, my Acharya's Acharya, the one who has the Atma with the personification and ultimate of unalloyed, natural, flawless bhakti, and without expecting any other fruits, Ananya Prayojana Bhakti, with Paramaikanti, he enjoyed only your lotus feet. Such great Yoga Purushar, Acharya Shrestar, Sriman Nathamuni, thinking of any association with him itself cleanses us. And as his grandson and as his Shishya's Shishya, please do not look down upon me for my papams. Please bless me with your Daya, with your grace, and have a Kataksham on me. Alavandar's final statement on the glories of the Anugraham and Sambandham of the Acharya for successful prapatti and inclusion of fearlessness, Nirbhaya, as a result of performing prapatti. Even he does not have the qualifications of his own due to Naichyanu Santana. So, Sriman Nathamuni had a complete sense control. He was a Yoga Shrestar. Asti Brahmeti Chet Veda Santatam Yenam Tato Viduriti Shruti. And based on that Shruti, he knew the Atma Sattai. He was blessed with Atma Sattai. And because of Sriman Nathamuni, Deha Sambandham and Acharya Sambandham. And so please bless me with your Anugraham, Alavandar says. And he concludes the verse. And Akritrima, he had unalloyed devotion. No vesham, no pretending, no acting. And he did not do just for popularity or for others to praise him. And he did not have that acting. So he had pure devotion naturally burst in him. So even in the second sloka, Alavandar says Nathamuni had Anuraga Mahimati Anuraga Mahima Dishayanta Simne. Similarly here, Prema Prakarshavadim. So that bhakti is unlimited, boundless bhakti and limitless bhakti. And Atmavantam, he focused his mind only on Lord's lotus feet and nothing else. And he attained, he was focusing, contemplating and having the dhyanam on Lord's lotus feet with no other prayojana. And he did not want a delay in reaching the Sri Vaikuntham, and hence he considered prapatti as the mokshopayam. He did not adopt bhakti yogam because he had an intense desire, quest, and he wanted, he had the twarai, the quickly he wanted to reach at the dehavasanam, at the end of his life. And like Perumal, Jnanitu Paramaikanti, Bhagavat Dhyana Yo, Bhagavat Dhyana Yo, Bhagavat Dhyana Yogokti Vandana Stuti Kirtanaihi Labdhatma. In Slokam 29, Sri Gitartha Sangraham, Swami Desikan himself says, one who does not go to Perumal for other fruits, and one who always contemplates on Perumal, one who has the dhyanam, uninterrupted dhyanam, even in Yoga Dishai, and meditating his lotus feet in the cavity of one's heart, and praising his glories, prostrating at his lotus feet, uttering his divine names, reciting his stotras. Like that, he had the Atma Dharanam. Such person is called Paramaikanti. And our Acharyan, my grandfather, is exactly fitting into that. And he knew exactly whatever that was in Dharma Shastram. He had learned the Vedas. He was the Vishnu Bhaktar. He was completely devoid of any jealousy. And he knew the mantra mantrartham on Sriman Narayana. He had the intense bhakti on the mantrams. And he had the nishtai as prescribed in the mantrams. And he had such a bhakti on his own Acharyan. And body, mind and speech. Whatever the word that he speaks, the action that he does and the thinking that he has, all three were acting in unison and they were completely pure. And he had learnt Itihasa Puranas. Thus, he was shining as the Acharya. Acharyo Veda Sampanno Vishnu Bhakto Vimatsaraha. In that Vachanam, this comes. All these fall exactly in a manner befitting to Sriman Nathamuni. Pitamaham, he is a Deva Sambandham with me. Tadrishti Gocharaha Sarve Muchyante Sarva Kilbishaihi Putra Preksha Tata Shishyaha. So, Adiyen also needs to be blessed by you based on that. Because of the Janma Sambandham, Vidyai Sambandham with Sriman Nathamuni. Hanumar, he is of course Vayu Putra, but he is also considered as Surya Putra by Bhojarajan. How? Because Anuman had learnt Sakala Sastras from Surya, the sun. And hence, because of Vidya Vamsam, he became Jnana Putra. Similarly, Sriman Nathamuni Shishyasa Uyakondar and Sri Manakkal Nambi. And Manakkal Nambi Shishya is Alavandar, Yamunacharya. Thus, Sriman Nathamuni is from Vidya Vamsam, Pitamahar. Deha Sambandham, Pitamahar. Hence, he has two Sambandhams with Sriman Nathamuni. Also, Chandogya Upanishad says, Nasya Avara Purushaha Kshiyante. Brahmavit, the Vedantic scholars, Brahmavit, their generations, their progenies, down the line, would not go down. They would actually be uplifted and saved, says this. Similarly, Mundaka Upanishad says, Nasya Abrahmavit Kule Bhavati. This Brahmavit Kulam, below the lineage of Brahmavit Kulam, would also become Brahmavit. That is what the Shruti says. So, Yamunacharya completely falls into that category in two ways. One is the Acharya Sambandham, other is Deha Sambandham. Vilokya. Hence, considering him, you need to have a kataksham on me. Prasida. Please bless me because of the Acharyan Anugraham. With Acharyan Anugraham, I would get whatever that I desire for. One should have unflinching faith in that statement. Then only, he only can get Sukham in this. And that is what says in Prapanna Parijatam by Sri Nadadur Ammal. Acharyasya Prasadena Mama Sarvam Abhitsitam Prapyuyam Iti Vishwaso Yasyasti Sa Sukhi Bhave. Sri Nadadur Ammal say. Similarly, Acharya Prasadam is with Adiye, and hence, please bless me with Devarir Prasadam, Bhagavat Prasadam, says Alavandar. Mat Vrittam Achintayitva. Adiyen would have performed very many follies, defects, mistakes, blunders, sins, papams,
But because of Acharya Sambandham alone, you should bless me. Punyashali Pundarika and Mahapapishta Chatrabandhu became Muktas because of Acharya Sambandham. That Sadacharya Sambandham is also with me. Hence, please save me. That is what is referred to here with Acharya Sambandham. So, though I had limitless unbounded papams and disqualification, as per my verse, Amaryada Hatshudraha, etc., due to my association with grandfather and Acharya, you need to bless me. So, when you could assure even Vibhishanas, who were even from Rakshasa Vamsam, can you, O Natha, leave me, who has the greatest Sambandham with Sriman Natha Muni? I have been blessed with your Jnanam as Acharya Prasadam. Here, some people may argue that it may be mistakenly interpreted that Alavandar says, even if you do not accept my Sharanagati, please bless me and save me due to my Acharya Sambandham. It is incorrect to say, because all the 64 slokas of Acharyan would have been waste if it is so. It's not that Alavanda suddenly got religion and he understood that which negates all the 64 previous slokas. Acharyas of Alavandar caliber would not do such gross blunders to compose 64 verses and then negate the earlier slokas with the 65th. It is only reinforcing his faith on the Lord and completing his Sharanagati probably. If the Sharanagati has got some lack of qualifications or prerequisites before, it has been made fully complete with the Acharya Sambandham, with the Deha Sambandham with Acharya Nathamuni, with the Vidya Sambandham with Acharya Nathamuni, and seeking his forgiveness, Perumal's forgiveness, for his probably future errors as well, and omissions after Prabhati till the final moment of his life due to Acharya Sambandham. So that is why we also need to contemplate our Acharya Sambandham and perform utter Taniyan of our Acharya every day, every moment, whenever we have time. Thereby, whatever the probable future errors and omissions after our Bharanyasam till the final moment, he is nullified, seeking Perumal's forgiveness every moment due to Acharya Sambandham. The meaning of Thayam is very nicely interlaced in the body of this wonderful Stotra Ratnam among the Stotrams composed by Alavandar. In the previous work, Chatusloki, our Acharya made Purushagara Prapatti to Sri Devi to mediate as a recommendation for his Sharanagati to Sri Devi. Thereafter, he begins to perform Bharanyasam Sharanagati at the lotus feet of the Lord. He completes Guru Parampara Anusantanam in the first step as a prerequisite, the first three verses. Then he elaborates next on the meaning of Narayana Shabdam and follows the arc of Dvayam and completes the Sharanagati at the sacred feet of Sriman Narayana. The second padam of Dvaya Mantram comes into focus now. Our Acharya now explains the meaning of Srimate Narayanaya section by stating that this portion stands for the attainment of fruit of Nitya Kaikaryam to Sri Vaikunthanathan in Paramapadam. He adds the next slokams that cover the Namaha section, the concluding word of Dvayam, for seeking Lord's Anugraham to eliminate any leftover obstacles in his effort to get the full benefit of Sharanagati. Nitya Kaikarya and Purna Anubhavam, Nitya Kaikarya Anubhavam, and Vadivil Kalamellam Udanayamanni Vadivila Adimeshaya Vendum Nam. Thus, the slokams of Stotra Ratnam can be considered to house and encompass completely the full meaning of the sacred Dvaya Mantra. That is why it is called Slokam is called Stotra Ratnam. Vishnu Puranam is called Purana Ratnam. Dvaya Mantram is called Mantra Ratnam. This slokam is called Stotra Ratnam. So let us recap the 65 verses. His analysis of the different sections that form natural grouping of thoughts is as follows. Number one, first slokam, Yamuna salutes the Acharyas who opened his spiritual eye, Slokam 1 to 5, and particularly his grandfather, Sri Ranganatha Muni. Number 2, beginning of the Stotram in Slokam 6. Then the awesome Paratvam of the Lord is hinted, and the insufficiency and diffidence of the composer Yamunacharya to tackle the profound subject of Paratvam is indicated in Slokam 7. Saulabhyam of the Lord is invoked to overcome the fear of such a profound topic, Slokam 8 to 9. Elaboration of Narayana Shabdartham, Slokam 10 to 21. Sharanagati performance, observance, Slokam 22, Nadharma Nishtosmina Chatmavedi. Declaration of his appropriateness and Adhikaram, the qualification, that is by Yamuna for the performance of his Prapatti, 23 to 27 Sloka. Statement of the fact that the simple to perform Prapatti has a completely disproportionately large dividend. That is what Arupayan Verilla Adiyavargal Anaivarkum Arum Adan Payanum Ivai Orukalam Palakalam Aru Orukalam Payan Palakalam means little, Payan very many. So large dividends 28 and 29. Revelation of the meaning of Uttarakantam of Dvayam, which deals with the fruit of Prapatti 30 to 46. Expression of his regret over hitherto so many wasted days, the wasted past, due to his lack of intensity to pursue the Prapatti and the fruits of Prapatti through the observance of the appropriate upaya, Slokam 47. Nirvedam over his missed opportunities and Mahavishwasam on the fruits to be gained by Prapatti. Number 48 to 51. Examination of the principles of Barasamarpanam, 52 to 53. Prayer to give strength to observe strictly the conduct of post-prapanna life, post-prapatti life, after performance of Sharanagati, till the end of his life, while being on this earth, Slokam 54 to 57. Statement of Lord's Karunyam, Sambandham, Bandhutvam, as the hope of his prapatti, 58 to 63. Reminding of the Lord of his Sharanagata Rakshana Vratam and prayer to include him in the Vratam. Slokam 64. Madegavarjam Kimitam Vratam Te. Did you exclude me when you took the Vratam? Number 16. Statement on the glories of Anugraham and Sambandham of the Acharya for successful Sharanagati and inclusion of his Nirbhayam, fearlessness, as a result of performing Sharanagati, even if he does not have the qualifications on his own with the Naichanu Santanam, and then because of the Acharya Sambandham, Slokam 65. The above summary was given by Shatakopan Swami of New York, and thanks to him that I could give the summary. The 65 verses are thus the sum total of Ashtakshara Mantram, Dvayam and Charma Slokam. This is the essence of Ragasyatrayam. Adiyen merely had a crude English translation with the lack of proficiency in English as well as in Sanskrit. Adiyen pays humble prostrations at the feet of Sri Uttamur Swami and his ardent prime Shishya Sri Vatsankachar Swami for both their wonderful, exhaustive, extensive, sweet Vyakhyanams in simple Tamil, and Sri based on Swami Desikan and Periyavachan Pillai's wonderful Vyakhyanam. It's a great delectable anubhavam even to read these Vyakhyanams. If there is anything found good in this of series, the credit goes to the most brilliant Vyakhyanams of Sri Uttamur Swami and Asmad Acharyan's Vailakshanya Kataksham and Anugraham on the Kaikaryams. All mistakes, blunders, fault are only mine. Please forgive me. Kavitarkika Simhaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha. Namo Narayana. Adiyen Acharya Trivedikale Sharanam. Yamunacharya Trivedikale Sharanam.